I'm spiritual, not religious. I'm female, not male. I'm Asian. I'm African American. I'm black. I'm white. I'm anti this or for that. How many different lines are you putting around yourself that are like a country? And you hold fast to what it means, like it's a religion. Imagine no possessions. This was hard. Ooh, boy, did I have trouble with this one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger or to sugarfy yourself.
You see Irvine?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's beautiful. It's grown so much.
To a sense of themselves, of who they are and who they aren't, and watching them express that in the various ways that they do. And one thing that I love about the concept of ArtLifeLive and how important art is to living life is that it's a way of expressing, and that you can express all kinds of things. One of the things I love to do is ask students to express a phrase. So what would it look like if you drew this phrase, "I have no doubt"? Like, what does that look like? And fearlessness, what's the drawing that connects you to your fearlessness? And what I have students do is beautiful paintings. Like, I want to share one.
Please.
This one is a student's painting that was from her capstone exercise. It was because she was dealing with feeling that she wasn't very beautiful. And she was confronting that feeling in her. And so she painted a rose, which is her favorite flower. She painted it as all of these individual dots. And what she wanted to communicate with this painting is that, A, I'm beautiful. B, all the little dots are a part of me. So some of them, if you just look at the dot, you may not see the whole picture. You just see the dots. But when you pull back, you actually see that it's magnificent. And some of the dots are darker, some of them are lighter. Mm-hmm. And she had a whole experience of herself as beautiful based on what she portrayed in this picture.
I love it.
And so I love how art allows people, you know, they say a picture speaks 1,000 words, and I really believe that, and that there are a lot of people trying to tell you their 1,000 words through what they can capture in what they can draw, or whatever their form of art is, whether it's their music or their dance or their poetry or their architecture or their painting.
Thanks.
I'm Valerie Sheppard, and you are watching Art Life Live.
Thank you, Valerie Sheppard. We're at UCI. Tell us what you do and some of your important work.
So I say that I'm a speaker, teacher, author, healer. And that's a lot of things coming together here on the UCI campus. My favorite thing is to teach a class called Living 101, Being Happy and Whole. And it's all about equipping the students with skills to create lives that they love to live. saltines, but it was a particular brand. Anybody have that, like, in their household? When you go to Grammy's house, it's a particular thing. Wow, thank you. Okay, so what we've been talking about is emotions. And some of what we learn about why we don't feel them is because we can't keep them under control. When I think about art, I have to tell you, for me, there's the greatest artist. To me, the thing that has spoken to me the most throughout my life is nature. Being in a setting like this, being by the ocean, mountains, lakes, looking at the big animals, looking at the teeny weeny little hummingbirds, nature awakens in me this sense of imagination, creativity, connectedness, oneness, helps me to see the magnificence of life and to actually connect to it such that I remember that's me too. Like, I see that juicy beautifulness as being a part of me instead of something that I just look at and admire. So nature is the number one work of art. Thank you, God, for that. And then there's probably a couple things. Growing up, there wasn't a particular artist, but I was really into the whimsical illustrations of in Dr. Seuss books. There was just such outrageous creativity, is the way I think of it today. I don't know what I thought of it then, but I just knew it made me smile and laugh on the inside, and I wanted more of it. And I wanted to, there was a sense of being larger than life, like not escaping into the book, but kind of leaping in and like jumping into that world and wanting to be able to create the Mac that, I don't know, there was fancifulness and magic and just an otherworldly sense that I could be that, and where the fanciful ideas going on in an 8-year-old girl's mind can actually be the life that she lives as 30. Of course, I couldn't think of 30 back then, but 30 or 40 or 50 or however old I might be. And then as I got older, I really fell in love with a couple of forms of artwork. I really love the architecture of Frank Lloyd Wright. So while it may not be a typical artist, his architecture, there's something in the lines and the spaces and how he fit his buildings into the environment that, again, speaks to that idea of nature and human beings coming together, and that there's a way for us to coexist that can be magnificent and beautiful and easy and in harmony and cooperative. And I like that about Frank Lloyd Wright's works. They're also, to me, cozy. Like, when I think of his buildings and his creativity, I think of like a warm blanket and a nice cup of chai green tea latte.
Yeah, yeah.
And then I think the last one, which was a little bit older than, was Gustav Klimt.
Oh,
and he's an Austrian-born painter and did a lot of paintings of women. But what I like the most were not necessarily his portraits, but there's one multiple pieces to it. It's called the Stocklet Frieze, and it has the Tree of Life. And what I like is the way he combined very beautiful gold filigree with like greens and pinks and even black and white to have this. Parts of the painting seem to jump off the background and other parts just seem incredibly real. And so I've got several Klimt paintings at my, well, not real ones, but prints in my house. And to me, that the whole body of work that I've just talked about, there are probably three things. To me, there's this sense of larger than life, but it also combines kind of this fanciful, magical, imaginative environment with something very real, and that to live right in that space where we're bringing magic into our reality. I mean, I teach that, I love it. And then there's this sense of nature and harmony and this whole piece of oneness. We are all together in this creation called life, and we're bringing to it whatever we can, and to be able to give and receive as others are bringing to it, that's in the art as well. And I think there's a sense, the last thing would be a sense of peacefulness, like that cozy, warm thing that art brings to any environment, this sense of, like that exhale, this sense of peace.
I think I saw it in your class, but really quickly, how can art work in our life to make us feel more alive, more present, more in the now?
I think it's when we are willing to quiet the head and stop the judging of the art and the needing to get a meaning from it and needing to be able to boil it down to a least common denominator or something that the mind can play with and let it be, like to allow, accept and receive it exactly as it is, and to be in the space of what is that? If I just accept it for what it is, what does it have to offer me? So to be in this, you know, like someone told me a long time ago, to really receive the trees and the flowers, like they want to be received. We basically walk through them and most of the time don't even notice. And sometimes I just want to say, hello tree, I see you. And it's this sense of with art, like to be in that open-hearted, open-handed space of give it to me, all that you have, and I will give you my attention, my affection, my love, and just my presence.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
And I just want to point out, there's a hummingbird around here. Have you heard it? That chortle bzzz.
Yeah.
That's a hummingbird. He's trying to let us know that, you know, hummingbirds are supposedly harbingers of happiness. And this is my book. They're also my favorite bird. But this is my book, Living Happy to Be Me. Living Happy to Be Me. Living Happy to Be Me. HappyToBeMe.net. HappyToBeMe.net. And there are some videos there where I talk about what's in the book and how it can help you to transform yourself and therefore transform your life into one that you really love living. HappyToBeMe.net, and the book is Living Happy to Be.
Sacred space. You brought that up in your classroom, and also Art Life Live thinks it's very important. What are some hindrances? What are some challenges do you think we face today to, I think you said, guard or protecting sacred space, to honoring sacred space, to even acknowledging sacred space?
Yeah, I think the most important thing is for everyone to create their sense of that sacred space. And what it looks like that is not sacred space is self-protection out of fear. Like, I can't show you what I'm really feeling or how I'm really thinking or what's really going on inside of me because you might judge me. You might think I'm less than or I'm not as smart or as pretty as the next person. That's not sacred space. That's just fear and self-protection. And sacred space is kind of being a container for whatever has to come up or whatever needs to be said or whatever needs to be shared, whatever needs to be given, whatever needs to be received. It's holding being a container for that to happen and trusting that there's a higher power that has it all underneath some divine orderly system. So even though we may look over there and see two people arguing and not understand it and want to go make it different, holding sacred space is while we're certainly protecting, like looking to make sure that everything's okay and that someone doesn't really need physical protection, that we're also in the space of calling in divine light and love into that moment and asking ourselves, you know, how do I be the divine light and love that's needed in that moment? What is mine to do? What is mine to say? And how can I be the highest and best version of me to deal with whatever's going on right now?
Action.
I'm Valerie Sheppard, and you are watching Art Life Live.